was encouraged to go on my own and start exploring my own Christianity. And obviously the other parts of being exposed to that sort of atmosphere as well with, and I went to a relatively religious state primary school. I have very close ties with the local church, and I've often had the local vicars in to give assemblies and things. And then as I progressed up into Scouts, with a lot of church praise, with all of church activities through Scouts. So I was exposed to Christianity from a very early age. And I suppose it was almost a default position for me then to be a Christian. Now saying that, I was actually quite an active member of the church and the sort of church society in the local area. And for the most part, I was happy with what the church was offering, what Christianity was offering. I believed in God, I believed in Jesus, I believed in the message they said and gave us. And as far as I can see, everything was happy, everything was fine. And then as I started to get a bit older, and started getting sort of secondary school, started learning a bit more about the physical world, the biological world, and how that interacts with the world personally, I started to find that the answers I was seeking sort of spiritually were starting to become a bit vaguer when answered by Christians, when answered by sort of my vicar and things. And things started in my own private study of the Bible, my own private study of Christianity. It things were starting not to quite match up as well as they used to. And I was starting to find it harder and harder to correlate what I was learning sort of science-wise. As well as those people-wise, I was obviously starting to get more interaction with more people at this time. And I was finding it harder and harder to match it up with what I was taught from Christianity. And one of my big problems was I was going through a really big physics phase. It probably just me being a little bit geeky, but I went through a massive, massive physics phase around the age of 13, 14. I got involved in electronics club at school and really got into the whole sort of cosmology side of physics. I've got a telescope and all sorts. And obviously, the sort of prevailing theories at the time regarding cosmology and physics, whereas there's a lot of work on Big Bang theory, there's a lot of work on sort of movement of galaxies and things. And I was starting to think, well, it's just a little too far away from the sort of view that's taught by Christianity. And I know there's a lot of sort of modernist Christians, a lot of apologist Christians, who try and marry up Christianity to science. And I always felt that was the wrong way around. Is that surely if we had a God, and if this God was so great, then we should be trying to marry physics up to what was created rather than the other way around. And so the answers I was starting to get regarding a lot of things in my life were starting to get a bit vague. And I started to question, was everything we were taught about Christianity right? Was everything correct? Was it just sort of my vicar's view? Was it just my parents' view? Were there different messages out there? And this was around the time that I was getting confirmed. So there's lessons and classes involved in that, and there's a lot of sort of development work that you try to work through a lot of your problems. And it came to confirmation. It was about a month before my confirmation, 6 weeks. And I was really starting to wonder whether I could actually make the sort of promises, make the sort of commitment that was really being asked of me. And it was sort of around this stage that some of the more sort of worrying parts of Christianity were starting to play on me. I was starting to think a lot about sort of the difference in God of the Old Testament and then God of the New Testament, and how sort of a period of about a year, before Jesus was born, after Jesus was born, there was such a sort of flip. I mean, I realise now that that's not wasn't quite as simple as that, but the Old Testament, the New Testament God were really starting to play on me. A lot of the problems in society as well started to play on me. It was like, well, what's the point in sort of worshipping God that stopped working 2,000 years ago and left us to our own devices? And it was because of that that sort of I postponed my confirmation. I went to speak to my vicar and I was like, this isn't the right time for me, I can't make the sort of commitment that's being asked of me. So I started to look at other things as well. And I was now comfortable 16, 17, moving up to 6th form. Obviously starting to get a better idea of the physical world, the physical sciences for A level. I sort of began to sort of see an appreciation of what else was on offer. And I started to look sort of more academically at religion and a variety of religions. And it sort of led me to sort of, when I was about 18, in the last year of my levels, and I sort of came to the conclusion that none of the religions that I seem to look at seem to answer any of the questions, not fully, not as much as I wanted. And it was sort of by chance that I then said, well, if I can't find a religion of this, what about the other choice? I mean, it's not something I've previously considered. Obviously, religion seemed to be the right area. Then I started to think, well, what if religion is not the right area? What if I need to look outside of that religious sort of sphere? I started to look at atheism, and I probably went through an agnostic phase for about 2 years. With the upbringing I had, I couldn't quite bring myself to sort of make that step away from any sort of God. And then I came to university about 4 years ago now, and I was probably about as an atheist and agnostic as you could get by the time I came to university. I was still agnostic, but I was very much leaning towards the atheist end of the spectrum. And then at university, obviously, you get quite a bit of spare time, especially in first year, to read. You get a lot of time to talk to a variety of people. I don't know how many of you experienced this. When I was in Paul's, I was in St. Mark's just across the road. All the sort of chaplains from all the faith groups at university came to visit the halls. And we had some outside agencies welcome to visit. And they all came up, sat in our kitchen, had a cup of coffee, and tried to convert us, basically, have a chat to us about what was on offer in the chaplaincy, what was on offer in their religion. And that sort of forced me into the thing that they were all telling all those the same story, and it all sounded so crazy. So I was sitting there purely from a, I'm going to sit here and you have to convert me to this aspect. It all sounded so crazy. And that led me to sort of read a few books and speak to a couple of people. And it was probably at that stage that I made the step into atheism. I probably took it a little bit too far and had a little prize ceremony for all the faith people that came around. So the Mormons won best faith because they're the ones who tried the hardest and have the craziest story. Just 5 minutes that I want to spend talking about how I got from that point when that's how I became an atheist. If I'm going to say that's the day I turned to atheism, then it was sort of third or fourth week of my first year of university, so it's about 4 years ago now. And then the development through it, because although I was an atheist, I didn't know anything about atheism, I wouldn't have called myself an atheist at the time. And I wouldn't really know what I stood for as an atheist, because I think there's a difference between being an atheist and being a religious and not having a religion. I think atheist requires a little bit of a positive step further than just nothing. Because although weak atheism or the weakest form of atheism is just a religion, just not having religion, not believing in God, sort of to actually call yourself an atheist, you actually have to go a step further, I think, and say, I don't believe in God. And sort of have a little bit more to back that up rather than just not caring or not having any thoughts on that at all. And that's when I sort of get into reading a little bit of Richard Dawkins. Now, I'm not Richard Dawkins' biggest fan, but I'm one of his big critics, especially in the atheist societies. It's my job to tell everyone to stop getting quite so worked up about Richard Dawkins. Now, obviously, he's a pretty good scientist, so I've read some of his more scientific work. But a lot of his sort of religious work I find is a bit too atheist. It's too let's turn atheism into a religion, let's go out there and evangelize, let's go out and tell people that atheism is great. And that's not quite what I think atheism is, that's not what I think atheism should be. But then I was started to read more and started to talk to a few more people. And it was about the time that the Atheist Society was sort of formed here, sort of end of 2005, sort of 2006, was it? End of 2006, but a year ago. Was really when I sort of said, well, although atheists tend not to be socially active together, they don't tend to sort of get together as atheists and do atheist things, they don't come to church. They don't sort of campaign, they don't do that sort of thing. But I saw Atheist, you know, I saw the mission statement, which was to promote not just atheism but secularism and rationalism. So I said, well, it sort of gave me an idea that there wasn't just atheism, there wasn't just I don't believe God, there was aspects of atheism and sort of branching from that tree that gave a little bit more depth, gave a little bit more perspective on life. And I started to read up about those and get involved with a few activities. I went to a few humanist meetings, and I decided that humanism probably wasn't for me. It's a bit too religious for an atheist, I always found. And I came across rationalism, and I read a few sort of rationalist pieces, and I looked back over the years and realised that the rationalism was actually a really good idea, because basically what I was, it's how to sort of reason and logic and conclude things from sort of a given set of evidence. And I immediately was drawn to that as a scientist, and as now I'm an engineer. I was drawn to that, and I came across it, and I was actually reading an essay, I can't remember who it was written by, but it was an essay about the development of concrete. And its effect on a variety of things. And it occurred to me as reading this that actually rationalism is so important in everything, even silly little things like the ingredients of concrete, that it didn't matter if you were an atheist or you were a Christian or a Muslim, but everybody should be rationalist. Everyone should have a rationale for everything they believe in. And I started then to compare sort of that sort of rational reasoning and logic to religion. And I found that the more I tried to put a reason to religion, the more sort of hypocrisy I found, the more sort of problems with the Bible, more problems with scripture, more problems with the clergy, the church, and various other parts of religion. And I started to find and think, well, surely if religion is so great and it's right, and whichever religion turns out to be the right one, if any is right at all, then they should fit to human thinking. Because even if God created humans, then humans must be able to comprehend what's been created. Otherwise, there's no point in God might as well not exist anyway. And so that's really where I stand today. I'll come to a rationalist, and I'm an atheist, I don't have a belief in God. And I'd probably go as far as say I'm quite a critical atheist. So it's not just enough for me to sit and say, I just don't believe in God. I feel the need to sort of, to create and express reasons why I believe that. Mainly justification, but also the sense of trying to sort of iron out some of the bigger problems with religion. I'm a massive secularist, I believe in separation of church and state, and that's one of the things that I joined Atheist Society for, was to get on board the secularist campaign and try and remove religion from state, from government, from law. And that's really where I am today. So, if you have any questions, I'll hand over to Chris, but I'm around at the end of this talk, so cheers.
Right, I'm going to struggle to follow that, so I think I'll try and keep this short and snappy. I always think it makes quite a good story when someone tells you, yeah, I've always thought a Christian or a Muslim, and I kind of came to the dark and So I think, like, a fudge shirt's not really my style of it, but it's a nice one nonetheless. I was raised in a fairly secular household. My dad's an atheist, my mum too. She was an agnostic, she's now an atheist. My first convert, I'm quite proud of that. I wasn't shielded from religion. I mean, I went to youth club that would get invaded. I went to scouts again that would get invaded by the church. I did the full GCSE in RE because I always found religion quite interesting. But someone said something interesting to me once, and that's that if nobody had heard about religion until you were, say, 16, nobody would believe it. And that's kind of where I came from. I was about 13, 14, 15 when I started thinking, well, this religion thing's quite important because if it is true, and I'm not believing it, I'm going to burn in hell forever. And I really don't want to burn in hell forever. That's something I'm trying to avoid as a general rule. So I started looking into it, and I went around all the major religions, and I just couldn't really find anything that kind of fitted into my worldview. Made a coherent worldview is probably a better term there. So my next step was to find out, well, where can I find some kind of coherent worldview? Can I say, modify religion? Can I come up with my own kind of thinking? And I couldn't really, and what I was left with was not much. And that's kind of my angle on atheism, that it's the only thing I found that forms some kind of coherent worldview. And I mean, I think it's one of the things I really like to focus on is to make sure that it still is. I mean, I try to go down to all the CU events. I go down to, say, ISAC events, Jewish Week, I'm there all to kind of find out what's going on. And the thing I come back to time and time again is these religions can't build some kind of coherent worldview for me because they're always coming up with answers and they really just don't fit for me. Especially when you get into more kind of fundamental religions, the more and more you go, the more and more you get division between what the scripture says and what the world seems to be like. And I think what atheism is saying is, well, we don't know. And it seems quite a cop-out to just say, well, we don't know where the universe came from. There's plenty of hypotheses floating around, but the basic answer is we don't know. And I think it's quite amazing that we can be so humble to say, well, yeah, we don't know, but we're going to figure it out eventually. And while that's not intrinsic to atheism, the religions I've looked at are always trying to fill these holes, and it just doesn't sit well with me, basically. So just to kind of run over through the background a bit, as I said, I started, you know, kind of experimenting with spirituality during my teenage years and really finding a thing. And then I came to the university and found that there were these huge religious societies and they were all outside and they were all giving you free tea and coffee all night and saying this, this and this. And I really felt there was a balance needs to be addressed there, which is why we got Atheist Society started. It was last December now, so almost a year ago. And a lot of people will tell you that they think their religion is amazing and they get so much out of it. Well, the other side for me for that would be that I get an amazing amount out of perhaps not atheism itself, but being involved with sort of the social side, you know, having the debates, after a meeting we would go and sit in the terrace and we'll debate for like 4 or 5 hours straight. And that's about the meaning of life, about ethics, about how we should live our lives. And I just really find that amazing. So that's what atheism is for me. It presents me with a coherent worldview, and I think I get a lot out of it as well. So that's basically my story in a nutshell. I think we're going to open it to questions now.